Oh, right, I think that dude.
Right, buff's good enough.
Let's have a look what it looks like.
Mate, we've done better than what the twins would have done, put it that way.
Anderson shelters were designed so that householders could easily put them together in their back gardens. The combination of curved, corrugated steel, half buried in the ground and covered with earth, made them incredibly strong. But they would have been a dark and damp place to spend the night.
Get in here and let's test it out.
I tell you what, you wouldn't want to be running and getting in here, that's for sure.
I'm well impressed with it. I hope Bruce likes it.
I've got to be honest, I mean, this is solid. That's not going nowhere.
That bed's quite sound, you know? I mean, you're not going to get a fantastic night's sleep on it, but you better wake up alive in the morning.
Yeah, I hope he appreciates all the work we put into this as well. You know, the new A-team here, innit?
What's the space like in there, mate?
You'd easily get two kids on the bottom and someone on the top, but some of these did take up to six people. Now we've done the beds, I think I might have a little bit of a lie down.
The A-team have delivered the goods just in time. Ross and Christoph from the computer game company have arrived. And after photographing some of the collection indoors, they want to get on with the shelter.
Well, there it is, look. So that's what we've
looks
done.
Looks fantastic.
You know, these two have just finished it off for me. Didn't take you long, did it?
We'll talk about that later, yeah?
OK, all right. Listen, Ross, this is Freddie. Freddie's our weapons expert.
How you doing? Nice to meet you.
Failed every maths exam he could at school, so he's my accountant and money man. This is Ross and his colleague, and they've come from Rebellion. Look at that camera he's brought with him as well. It's not like your normal, you know, Instamatic, is it?
Ross wants to create a 3D model of the shelter before and after an encounter with a Nazi bomb. So Christoph is taking hundreds of pictures from every angle possible. He'll feed them into his computer program to produce a 100% accurate model that will feature as an interactive object in their game world. And once he's done, yours truly will supply the bang.
We worked really hard on that. I reckon that's just as good as a wartime one.
You reckon that's bomb-proof then?
Well, it wouldn't take a direct hit, but it's going to do the job that it did in the war.
Well, let me tell you, they come up here to really try and get something authentic. Why don't one of yous two get in there while we let the blast off?
I'll go in there.
Yeah, you'd go in? Yeah. You'd both? No, no, let's make it fair, right? We'll toss for it, right?
All right, OK.
Right, one of you go in there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you're confident that's made as good as wartime, you're going to be laughing.
I never expected to actually be in it.
Well listen, really, right, listen.
If you're confident...
Heads or tails, heads or tails?
Heads, mate.
Tails.
Oh, I'm gutted.
Great.
So, that's you.
All right,
and what we do is we get the boys to put a little bit more warmth in the explosions, right? Just to really recreate the atmosphere of shock and awe. All done, yeah?
All done.
So you've got all the photographs, you're happy with everything you got so far then, yeah?
Fantastic, got everything we needed, but now we need to scan something that looks like it's been blown up.
To impress my clients, I've prepared three blasts to recreate a cluster of bombs falling nearer and nearer to the shelter. What Freddie doesn't know is that the first two won't quite be up to the old school Luftwaffe standards. Blowing up the staff isn't good for business.
Freddie, get your camera. Make sure you film it. Right, well, let's just do this then.
You got your nappy on?
OK, Freddie, you ready? Yeah? OK. 3, 2, 1.
Freddie!
Is he alive?
Yeah, he's fine, he's come out.
How was that?
That was no problem at all. This thing's perfect. Make the next one bigger.
Okay, no problem. You sign that document, I'm happy, all right? We'll give him bigger.
Right, let's give him bigger. Let's do it, yeah, let's do this. Get ready for the next one, he's coming!
3, 2, 1.
You are there, son!
He's still here!
I've got to tell you, I am glad I ain't in there now.
You can see why they put a toilet in there, can't you? You need it, right? You know, let's go and have a look. How is that?
I have seen that this has withstood the blast from a sort of bomb from the Blitz, but my eyeballs are rattling around in here. Dan played the thing, he's put his money
where his mouth is. But that was just for starters.
I want your players to see something as realistic as possible, and hopefully with what we're about to do, which is a 50-kilo bomb going off near an Anderson shelter. Hopefully this is going to be perfect, right?
50-kilo general-purpose bombs were designed for use against vehicles, troops and buildings, and one could easily destroy a house. So I think I'll sit this one out.
OK, right, firing. 3, 2, 1.
Hey, Brady, I'm glad you weren't in there, mate. Mate, that was good. I enjoyed that one.
If you were in there, you probably would have survived.
What do you reckon, chaps?
Wow. Hey, I felt it.
Proper explosion. Yeah. That was like a double tandoori vindaloo.
Given the size of the blast, I'm impressed with how well the shelter held up. Freddie and Ouse must have read the instructions for once.
So, Ross, that should enable you to do your photographs of after, I think, yeah?
Yeah? That's perfect. I've never seen anything like it.
Well, there you go. You imagine being in that thing. That's got to look great in a computer game. I'm chuffed with that, and you? Yeah, really chuffed.
This looks awesome. You can't beat the real thing.
Ross and Christoph also love the other Blitz items I've got for them. And they're already talking about coming back for more. Mission accomplished.
The stories my mother's told me about this place is just incredible.
Tracking down war relics from the Blitz.
Well, look at that. Well, that's incredible.
Taking my business in an entirely new direction. And best of all, see my collection 3D scanned so it can be used in World War II computer games. Awesome.
If you were in there, you probably would have survived.